The most beautiful place in the world, where a Tar Heel blue sky blankets Murphy on its way to the Tennessee border. It's a long way from Raleigh and the Outer Banks, but we're living in Carolina too. In fact, you might call it extreme Carolina. With more, here's Michael Borkman.
Welcome everyone to the show, Extreme Carolina, the show that focuses on great people with great stories who prove in their lives, everyday lives, that anything is possible. We strive here to bring you relatable life lessons from interesting and inspiring people as they live out their purpose on this earth. And today, it's time for some good news that you can use, because today we have in the studio, in the chair with us today, Mr. Ron Lambright. And Ron, he's the owner of Hometown Sleep Center right here or down the road in Hiawassee, Georgia. Amazing guy, dad, husband, all around businessman. And we are just glad he's here. So welcome to you, Ron.
It's good to be here.
Hey, man, I'm glad that you are here. We spent a couple months trying to get this together, but we finally did get it together, man. And so we are just so blessed to have you in the studio on Extreme Carolina.
Well, there's no place I'd rather be this morning.
Well, I'll tell you what. What we're going to do is just, we're going to dive right into it, because we don't have long. This thing goes really, really fast. And so what we like to do is, before we get started too far, we like to find out what it took or what happens, because in life, success just is not success. I mean, it's built on failures.
And change.
You're right. And so our listeners like to hear from our guest of a time that they failed in their life and what they learned from it. And we don't want, you know, like the Reader's Digest version, but just a little short one on a time that you fail and how you pick yourself up. And, well, what did you learn from it? Can you share that with our listeners real quick?
Sure. I'm sure a lot of people have had issues similar to what I've been through, but
yeah.
I had a pretty good long career, about 20 years in the music business.
Okay.
And then it was just time for a career change. And so
okay.
That can happen, you know.
Yeah, it can.
And I had a lot of great experiences along the way and a few mm-hmm. disappointments. And the thing I learned mostly is just never give up and
wow.
keep looking ahead. You know, you can't change the past.
No, you can't.
You can deal with the present, which determines your future.
Wow. That's almost repeatable.
It is.
I think, as a matter of fact, say if you know, that's something that I would like for our listeners to make sure. I don't want to unpack it, but I would like to that bears repeating one more time.
The like past. I said, it can change. You cannot change the past.
Okay.
But you can deal with the present, which definitely affects the future.
Amen to that, brother. Amen. Well, I tell you what, we'll come back to the other side of that a little bit later. But for right now, let's just keep it moving. And right now, though, Ron, you're here in Hiawassee. You're doing some things. You're not maybe changing the past, but you're helping some folks that have had a bad past or something similar to that.
Yes. Of course, everybody knows all about Hurricane Florence that came in and literally wiped out Wilmington, North Carolina.
Yeah, it did.
Myrtle Beach,
right.
A bunch of counties all around there, thousands and thousands of people. And even though that happened a couple months ago and it's kind of gone off the headlines of the media,
months?
It has been.
Wow.
And we've even had a whole other hurricane since then, Hurricane Michael. but you know, when these hurricanes come, they often destroy everything. And after a week or two, it's out of the news,
right.
But the problem is still there.
That's
right. What we're trying to do now. I own the Hometown Sleep Center there in Hiawassee.
Yeah,
mattress
we mentioned
store.
It. Yeah, okay.
And we are actually starting a hurricane relief effort to try to get donations to basically buy mattresses, brand new mattresses, to be given away to people who are devastated by the hurricane.
Like, given away, like free.
Absolutely given away. We're not making any profit on it or anything.
Nice.
It was kind of a neat idea of how it came. I actually heard about what Clay Logan and some were doing over
in
Hayesville.
Yeah, new commissioner over in Hayesville.
Yeah, and they were doing a hurricane relief thing shortly after the hurricane.
Right.
And the thought just came to me and says, man, why don't I do that? I could help. You know, it's not everybody's in a position that I'm in. And so I contacted, we do Sealy and Simmons mattresses, and I talked with the Simmons people.
Mm-hmm.
And I was real glad to find out they were actually planning to do something corporate-wide. But when they found out about a local business trying to help someone over there. They jumped right in on it.
Yeah.
Wow.
You know, I tell you what, you know, that is, well, before I say that, thank you, everyone, for tuning in today. If you just turned in, this is Extreme Carolina, and today we've got the owner of the hometown mattress center.
Sleep center, mattress,
but you sleep on a mattress. Sleep center. But anyway, thanks for joining us here at Extreme Carolina. And you were just talking about being able to be in a position to help someone, which is so amazing. And it's kind of like this show, which is what we like to do. We've been given this opportunity, this platform to help people. And so when I heard about this, that you were doing that, I wanted to interview you, man. I wanted you on the show to talk about that, because you have actually the only sleep center mattress store in Hiawassee. Is that right?
In Hiawassee, yes.
Yeah, okay. Now, not that Hiawassee is not a big, thriving metropolis or anything, but but it is a good-sized town. I think it's bigger than Hayesville.
It is. That's a great accomplishment.
I don't know how much that's saying, but it's bigger than Hayesville. But anyway, so you were moved to do something, and you're actually in a position to do something. And that's just so, it touched my heart that you were doing that. So let me say thank you.
Well, you know, everybody, if they'll look at their situation, everyone is in a position to do something for someone, but people in different positions. I happen to own a mattress store. Somebody else might have some other business, but our business is not just to make money and pay the bills. Our business is to help other people. And so my situation here is that we are going to collect donations.
Okay.
And basically, as much money as we get, that's how many mattresses we're going to buy. And even the mattress, I mentioned Simmons, they were wanting to help. They're going to sell the mattresses to us at lower than our normal cost. And the
you
mattresses,
like that?
they're going to ship. They're not even going to ship here to Hiawassee. They're going to ship directly
straight to
Wilmington, North Carolina. I've got, there's an organization over there, and you can find them online. It's the Harrelson Center.
Okay.
And if you go to www.harrelsoncenter.com or .org, I think it is.
Okay.
You'll find out all about them. But they are a nonprofit organization that is currently coordinating relief efforts from numerous organizations trying to help. And so I talked to the director over there, and they have someone that's going to check in the mattresses when they come. They'll be sure that they're given away free to people that need them. And they're even going to be specific. You know, if someone had, you know, insurance and insurance is going to buy them a bunch of new stuff, that's not even who they're trying to give the mattress to. They're trying to get them to people
that actually need it,
that are destitute. And you know, some of them people are sleeping on the floor over there.
That's really powerful.
And then we use some of the donations to buy some bed frames and a few sheets, but it's primarily going to be for mattresses.
That is so powerful, Ron. I really appreciate you sharing that. Now, let's say I'm hearing this show, and I know there's a lot of folks hearing this show. Let's say that I want to do something. So, do I have to come to the store, or can I find you online, call you? How do I get in touch?
Of course, they can always find us at hometownsleepcenter.com. You can call the store at 706-970-2025.
Okay.
Or you can just stop by. We're right on Main Street, across from Bannister Funeral Home, near McDonald's and the Always Christmas Plaza, 695 Main Street.
Okay.
And you can stop by the store, make a donation there of any size, and then we can...
Right.
We can help you.
So you're actually in your heart, you're the moving force here. I mean, you'd love it if people came and donated, but you've already decided that you're going to have some mattresses sent that way.
Yeah.
And these are the same mattresses that are in your store.
Well, there's one particular one that it ships in a box, and we're going to ship that one over there because of the shipping situation, make it a lot easier.
Okay.
And I have one similar to it, but I've actually got them to use a special one that I don't even have in the store. And there again, that's because it's the most convenient for the people there. But it's a good, comfortable mattress.
So they're not just getting some hand-me-down, throw-away, used mattress.
It's brand new.
Brand new mattresses.
Right, and they've got the warehouse to hold them until they get them distributed. Everything's all taken care of there.
So, but we're on the sort of like a deadline here, right? I mean, you're going to shut this off at some point, or it just goes on and on and on?
We're going to run it at least until January 31st.
Okay, 2019.
Depending on response after that. There's always more disasters coming, but this is primarily a focused event to help the people there in Wilmington.
Okay. All right. So then, so everyone has a little time left. I mean, I know this is coming up on Christmas times. People are, buying their toys and whatever, but if you got a little extra.
Well, and here's the thing about it. You could give several hundred dollars if you'd like, or you could give $1,000, or you could give $20.
Okay.
All of us going into one pot, and however much money we collect, that's how many mattresses we're going to buy.
Okay. Well, I tell you what, we're coming up on a break right now, so we'll finish this on the other side. But don't go away, everyone. We'll be back with Ron Lambright, the owner of Hometown Sleep Center. Be right back.
Tar Heel basketball, Cam's Panthers, Asheville's eclectic nightlife, and the Great Smoky Mountains. It belongs to us, too, out here in extreme Carolina. Once again, here's Michael Borkman.
Welcome back, everyone. Welcome back to the show, Extreme Carolina. And today we have with us Mr. Ron Lambright. This guy's an amazing guy. He's done a lot and doing a lot. But we're so grateful for the things he's doing now with the hurricane relief effort with sending mattresses straight to people who need it. Man, my hat's off to you. Good job. Amazing. But we'll finish on how people can contact you and find out how they can help in this thing. But now, before we get to that, let's back up a little bit and find out how you got here. How in the world did a guy like you, with your background, which I know it because I read the bio, that a guy that has got 20-plus years of being a worship leader, mm-hmm. right? Okay. And now you're the owner of a mattress store. I'm sorry, sleep center.
Yeah. Well, it's best. That's a big detour, isn't it?
That's a huge detour, man.
Well, basically, I was in church music ministry full-time for 20 years and okay. Was over in near Spartanburg in a town called Duncan, South Carolina.
Hey.
And working at a church over there. And like I said earlier, it became sort of time for a career change, and we got into retail. I sold insurance for a little while and then into retail, and I was a manager of a major mm-hmm. furniture store over in the Spartanburg and Greenville area.
Sure.
And my wife and I, we always loved coming to the mountains. We vacationed here many, many times.
Beautiful.
We knew that one day we would retire somewhere between Asheville, North Carolina, and Toccoa, Georgia. Okay. And about 7 years ago, my brother was up here, bought a piece of property to build a house here on the lake.
Okay. Sure.
And I told my wife, I said, why keep working in the city and then retire to the mountains? Let's just go ahead there now.
Yeah.
And so we came over literally in one day. I found a job in a furniture store over here, worked there a few years, mm-hmm. and then just felt it was time to open my own place. And that's how we got here.
What facilitated the mattress store or the sleep center? Why couldn't it have been an auto parts store or candy store or whatever?
Well, and the way it connects, I was in music ministry. That's all really, there's a lot of things to it, but a lot of it's communication, talking to people, listening to people. And that's how I got into retail.
Okay.
And when I was at the furniture stores, mm-hmm. Ashley Furniture Store was a huge one. And they would bring in the mattress trainers from Sealy and Simmons and Tempur-Pedic and all those, and they would tell about their particular products. But my specialty in the whole furniture industry was mattresses, and they would use me to actually go to the other stores to train them on how to sell the products. And so I always,
had a niche.
And I always like helping someone get a good mattress, because that's how you get a good night's sleep.
Amen.
When you get a good night's sleep,
you can
the next
get up,
day, you're just better to go. You're more creative.
Absolutely.
You're mentally sharper.
Okay.
And so it's always sort of about helping people. Mm-hmm. And so when I decided to open my own store, I really had no interest in opening a furniture store, but I wanted to do the mattress side of it. And so we do that.
And there you go. And that's how you got to
it. Yeah, we love it. And so fantastic. Many people come in and they say, I learned so much about mattresses from you, and it helps them make the right decision.
I know I have, and I've just been around you a couple times, man, and I learned some every single time. Mm-hmm. I mean, I still haven't tried out that Titan Osaki chair. I'm looking forward to doing that.
You get a good massage right there. That's a new product we've added. We have a whole lineup of the Titan Osaki massage chairs.
Oh,
they're really nice.
Cool.
And something new that we've just added is camper mattresses. You know, a lot of people around here, there's so many camper areas.
All over the place.
Man, we have mattresses now that you can get specifically for campers.
Nice. Okay.
RVs.
All right. You RV camper peoples out there, y'all hear this? Ron's got them. Okay, Ron, but let's keep it moving. Let's keep it moving. And for everyone who's just joining us, this is Extreme Carolina 95.1. You're here with Ron Lambert and myself, your host, Michael Levi Borkman. And today we're talking to Ron about this thing he has that was put in his heart to help other folks, which I just love. I love that. But before we get to that, usually we ask people that are here, we ask them about their reading habits, because it's important to continually to learn and to read. And so, and the question we like to ask folks is, what book have you read recently and what was the impact it had on you and that you could share with us? So is there a book that you've read recently that had that?
One that I try to read regular is the Bible, and that affects every single day.
That's a good one to read.
But I knew you asked your guest this question, so I went back and reread a short book I could answer this question.
And here you go.
The truth is, I read a book when I was a little kid. It's called The Little Red Hen.
Okay.
I believe that book should be required reading for every children and honestly adult today.
Really?
Because the basic story of The Little Red Hen is that the red hen had a piece of grain, and he came back to the farm, and she asked the pig and the dog and the horse and the cow, who wants to help me plant it?
Right.
Nobody did. Who wants to help me harvest it? Nobody did.
Right.
Who wants to help me mill it? Nobody did.
Right.
Who wants to help me turn it into bread? Nobody did. Finally, the little red hen did all that herself.
Okay.
And then when she cooked the bread, she said, well, who will help me eat the bread? And of course, the cow and the pig, everybody wanted it. But you know, that's the way it is in life a lot of times. There's people that they just don't want to work.
Hello.
But they want all the benefits
of it.
They
do.
And in our society, we need more and more people willing to work. And that book has really impacted my whole life.
Wow. You know, and the name of the book again was
The Little Red Hen.
The Little Red Hen.
Go on YouTube. You can find it there.
Okay, YouTube. We find everything on YouTube.
That's true.
Yeah, that's for sure. Okay, well, then we will keep it going. And we also like to add, and I like that answer. That was good. I'm going to make sure we put that, The Little Red Hen, on our Facebook page, or the show notes, as we call them,
sure,
so that people can go there and check this stuff out, like we're going to do with the mattresses here in just a few minutes. But before we get to that, we also ask, what's the best advice you've ever received? We like to ask that of every guest. So since you practiced the other one, I guess you got one of them ready for me too.
it simply is, don't give up. Everybody
give
has
up.
Problems that they face. Just don't give up. You don't have to do the whole rest of your life. You just have to do today. And then you do tomorrow.
Wow.
One day at a time.
Now that is amazing. That actually is so powerful. If I could, well, I want to unpack it, but we don't have time. But let's do this. Let's just keep it going and find, because you're in a position of a leader.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the other question we like to ask all of our guests is your view or your opinion of what a leader is.
Mm-hmm.
And it always varies from person to person. But we like to ask this question anyway. So we're going to ask you, in your opinion, Ron, what is a leader?
A leader is someone who knows where they're going and has confidence to take a step to get there.
Really?
You have to choose. A quote I heard years ago that really meant a lot to me.
Okay.
It simply said, on the plains of hesitation bleached the millions of bones of those who on the dawn of victory sat down and died.
Ah, so close. They were so close.
They hesitated and just didn't move. And a leader has to be willing to take a step when nobody else will.
Nobody
see, it's the people that step second, they're the followers.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
the leaders that lead.
Yep, they lead. Take that step. And don't give up.
Absolutely.
Because you're right close to your prize when you're ready to give up. Just one more step. Just one more. Just get up one more time.
And you never know how much farther it is till you hit that victory. It might be just around the next corner, or it might be around a whole bunch of corners, but it's out there.
Keep going. Man, thank you for that. Now, okay, we're getting real close, so I want to bring up about what you're doing again, which is raising money for the relief effort for the hurricane victims.
Hurricane Florence that hit Wilmington, North Carolina.
All right. And you're doing?
What we're doing is we're collecting donations from everyone here in Western North Carolina, okay, Northeast Georgia, to simply donate, come to the Hometown Sleep Center and donate. All the money that's given will be used to buy mattresses to be shipped directly to North Carolina.
All right. They can go to your website, which is
www.hometownsleepcenter.com.
All right. They can go there, or they can come in there and
absolutely
just give you money.
Okay. Absolutely.
Well, fantastic. Well, we're at the end, Ron. We got to shut it down. And, man, it went so fast, but it was good. Thank you for coming today. We really, really appreciate it. And so thank you, Ron. So, but what we like to do is end our show on a good positive note every time if we can, because Extreme Carolina is committed to you, our listeners, to bring you leaders and newsmakers like Ron that are passionate and purpose-driven and making a difference, which is what you're doing. Thank you, Ron. We really appreciate it. And to end our show, we have a quote of the day. Drum roll. That was a drum. And so here it is. The more one gives, the better one feels. The better one feels, the easier it becomes to give. Thank you, Ron Lambright. Appreciate you being here. Thanks, everybody, for listening. We appreciate it. God bless you. Peace.
In North Carolina, staring up the road and pray to God I see headlights.